Here we are at a National Historic Landmark, the Wheeling Suspension Bridge. We're on the bridge. It's a suspension bridge. And here's something interesting. See this? It's not steel. It's wood. Walking here is a little bit scary, especially if you are not comfortable with heights. Here's a view of the Ohio River. The cables dip below the railing. And here's the point where the railing is higher than the cables. Let's look back. See how high the cables go? And then this happens. The design of the bridge that we're on is so different from the one across the way. That's a beautiful steel arch bridge. Oh my gosh, I just found something of interest, and that is that the truss structure is made of wood as well. It's not just the top portion. We're more than halfway across. We must be in Ohio. Or at least we'll be there shortly, only another few footsteps away. We're at the point now where the cable is above the rail level. I almost didn't notice it with my excitement about entering Ohio. How about a little view of the water below? Splish splash. It's so much fun being on this bridge, and the air is just wonderful. With a slight breeze, I'm in total ecstasy. This is an open grid where the cars pass. You can see the water below. We've made it to the other side. Here's another sign for the bridge. It says this notable American engineer, Charles Elliott, designed the Wheeling Suspension Bridge, completed in 1849. For all my excitement about thinking that I was headed into Ohio, I found out when I got to the other end of the bridge that to get to Ohio, you still have to cross a bridge beyond this. Crossing the bridge actually brought us to this point, Wheeling Island. The view back, it's a bit different. We're able to see downtown Wheeling. There's a really interesting sign in the distance. It says Marsh Wheeling Stogies. Here's a historical marker for the Wheeling Suspension Bridge. It says that it was constructed by Charles Elliott Jr. between 1846 and 1849. It was the first long-span wire cable suspension bridge in the United States. For many years, it was the longest clear-span bridge in the world. The deck, however, was wrecked by a violent storm in 1854. It was rebuilt, and the structure with its original towers and cables are still in service. It is the most significant remaining pre-Civil War bridge in the nation.